The app Inventor launched their new interface. So let me show you that. As you can see here, it's the old interface they have right now. Now, let me show you how we can access that new interface. So you can see the setting options. Click on this and we'll see the user interface setting. Now you can see select interface style, the classic and new. Now I'm going to select that new and okay. So we can see that's the new UI of App Inventor. Now, as you can see here, they have mentioned a lot of things in the top here. And you can see you can create a new project. Now you can directly import the project from here, import the AIF file, and you can create a folder using this. Okay. And as you can see here, you can export your projects from here. You can move, you can just select the project and you can move all these projects to the new folder. And you can directly go to the gallery here and you can publish using this button. You can connect. You can see the connect option. You can connect your app with the companion, emulator, USB, and you can refresh them and hard reset them. Okay. Now you can see the build option. The same is like you can use the Android APK or AV file. In the right side, you can see the trash options. You can check it. Okay. So there's no trash till now. So let's go back. Now let's create a new project. Click on new project and say first new project new. Now that's the UI. In the left side, you will see the all the component like this. Okay. And you will see the all component is the same as it is, but their icons color is changed. There's no color actually, especially there's no color for the component. These are the black and white theme, something like say you can say. And yeah, it's overall good. Okay. And you can see the drag and drop thing, the same like this. You can see the properties like this. You can just okay, I don't like this thing because see, you can see here that it's a long name. That's why that bar width is too much. So let's try to rename this to the new horizontal arrangement something and okay. And it's done. But still, I can see here the horizontal arrangement, this one. Let me just refresh it because I really don't like that much space. Let me just try to, remove that space from here or let me just make it hide. Oh, I can't see. I can do this. Let's try to refresh it and let's see again. And yes, but when you click on this arrangement, that bar is automatically increase the width. So I don't like this feature because if I choose to add the big name here, suppose like this much of name, and let's click on OK. And if I just select this, and my bar going to be like this. Oh my god, that I don't like it. But I think they still are working on this. So I will suggest them like they should fix that issue. Okay, so they can do this. And now for now, we need to fix our. So let's do it here like this. Okay, I can't use that name, HR new name. Okay. That's good, I think. Yeah, we're fine. But I think this is the one issue I found. But it's overall good thing. Like you can see the rename and delete button here. You can add all the things like this. Now let's try to go to the block section. That's the block. So let's go to the control. You can see the if else conditions here, horizontal arrangement. And it's overall good. It's good. It's really good. Go to the design. You can add the buttons here. Like go to the block. Add some buttons. It's pretty much faster, I feel, as compared to the, you know, the previous version. And that's really good. It's really cool. Amazing. If you have any doubt, any question, you can ask in comment. Thank you so much for watching this video. Have a nice day. Be safe. Bye-bye.